Welcome back to the back nine of the first round of Bill and Ted's Awesome Disc Golf Adventure Finals from Live Oak, Texas, just outside San Antonio. You're watching GK Pro. After the front nine, Tim Escobedo's at 2 under par. Mason shooting hot so far at 5 under. Tanner still trying to get it going at 1 over. And Ezra has fought back to 1 under. Now we're going into the more wooded section of the course where you're really going to see some of the technical proficiency of the golfers shine through here. Hole 10 is what I consider the hole you need to get through. Par 5, 811 feet, 247 meters through the woods. This is a tough one. You kind of have a slight uphill drive with a tight lane that bends to the right. Right around here, just in front of the tee pad, is a super ideal landing zone, and you could do a few things. You could throw a chip hyzer out to the next opening that you're seeing now, or you can play it right down the middle, right at that center oak tree. Second shot landing zone would be right around here. And then your approach shot kind of climbs back up the hill and around those trees. I mean, this hole is a true snake of a hole. This is a really, really tough four, even for a top level player. It takes a great deal of accuracy and some power through the low lines. So here we go. We got Tim on the box. Oh, that's looking a little left, but it's got a nice drift on it. Ooh, kicks back into the fairway. That was a fortunate break. Now here's Mason Ford. I expect him to really dissect this hole. Oh, needs to turn just a little bit. Oh, tough kick out to the left. He might still have a good look from there. Ezra going with the two finger off the box. Smash. Oh, he basically ran into the two that you want to hit. If you can barely miss them, it's a perfect shot. Quality throw there. Tanner also opting for the flick, and he has just barely cleaned the gap. It's a little tight, but well played. I'd say that's the shot of the group. Tim just made sure that he got it out into the open for his next shot. And Ezra biting off a little bit more. He's going to have an opportunity to smash one through the lane and get a look at the four if he plays his third shot well. It was kind of a risky play. I like it. Wow, Tanner doing the same thing. That's in really good position. Mason showing his flexibility. A nice patent pending from the knee. Slid it through the gap. That's a good position. Oh. Man, Ezra has a lot of power. That one was just a little bit turned over. What else? He was going to fly up there and get a look at birdie. Uh-oh. I don't know if that was a roller or a throw. I'm thinking he was going for the roller here. Just went a little to the right on him. Now Tanner with the strong flick shot. Ugh, what a bummer. That was such a good throw. Just caught the first one, dropped straight down. Mason on what looks like his third shot. Or no, that was his fourth shot. So that's, I believe that's a putt for his five. Great camera angle from our boys at GK Pro. That was a beautiful line. Tim making it look effortless. Ezra throws one up there. Kind of hit a rock, but he should be close enough to tap that. Tanner's going to have a tap out. Mason for par. Great scramble. Five is a good number on this hole. Like I said, very difficult hole to four. Takes two or three really, really good shots on this hole. Tim's going to take a bogey. A good putt from Ezra. That'll get him in for par. You know, Tim's kind of on the roller coaster right now with a double on eight, a birdie on nine, and now a bogey on 10. I think he's going to be all right, though, because a bogey on 10 doesn't, it's not going to kill your round. I mean, it's not exactly what you want, but still not losing that many strokes. Hole 11, what I consider the easiest hole on the course. Just up and over the hill at 192 feet. Basically, when you're on the tee pad here, you'll see a branch. That oak branch that Mason's kind of flying at, that signifies the distance of the hole. That might have too much steam on it. That was a good stop. Yeah, that stopped pretty well. He's going to be inside the circle. Here's Ezra. Looks like he's going with a Discraft mid-range. And just a nice little chip. That's got good speed. A little bit of fade on it, but he's up above the basket inside the circle. Tanner playing the more overstable mid-range. He's also going to have a putt, maybe a little bit obstructed from the tree, but he should be able to handle that. Is Tim playing the drop? He is. Smart play. 2 meter rule is in effect at this event. But I like that play. That's one way to control the distance. Good putt from Mason. Back up the hill. Quality stuff. Maybe about a 26 footer. Tanner's up and in through the trees. Now Ezra's got maybe a right on 20, right about a 20 footer. That was dead center. And Tim, what I'll call playing the local route, throwing it right into the tree branch and letting it fall down. Birdies around, and on to number 12. Another pretty short hole, 212 feet, 64 meters. Ideally, you've either got a nice little chip flick shot or maybe a touchy backhand putter that drifts down the hill. You see there's the V-tree there and one other little kind of squiggly oak that might get you and keep you outside the circle. But if you can miss that, I expect a lot of the guys to put it right up in here within 20 feet. Looks like Mason's opting for the forehand. And is that going to be inside the trees? Sure is. Whoa, he almost aced it. Just short of the ace. Good run. He's going to have a putt. Here's Ezra. He's going to opt for the flick as well. Looks like he's going with a zone. Oh, that was excellently played. Just inside those trees. Is that a Yeti sighting in the background? Oh my gosh. Tanner. I mean, that's bread and butter for Tanner. Kind of a unfortunate kick off the squibbly tree like I was talking about. Those are the ones that can really stop a good shot. But he's still got a putt. What a shot from Tim. That was oh my gosh, I was within a meter. That almost aced it. Just a bit outside for Tanner on the birdie run. Here's Mason, and he got out to about, this is maybe a 25 footer. Nice stick. Great putt. He moves to 7 under. Well, he is rolling right now. That putt is looking so clean. Well done. Tanner taps out his par. That's just unfortunate break there, catching that tree. Ezra in for his birdie. Quietly marching up the leaderboard at 3 under. And Tim moving to 4 under. Couple of birdies negating those tough holes he's had. On to hole 13, where our players can open it up. 570 foot, 173 meters. It's a par 4. You've got OB on the right side in the culvert. And that's about all you got to watch out for. You know, main thing is you hit the gap off the tee. It kind of makes you swing it out to the right a little bit. But I expect these guys to smash some hyzers and put some birdies on this one. This is a very gettable par 4. Got a nice little crowd of players out watching these guys on a Friday afternoon. Mason going with the boom boom. Oh, getting the ground play as well. Wow. Yeah, please sit down. Now I'm excited to watch Ezra throw this one. This dude's got a cannon. Oof. Unleashing the fury. Stay up. Oh, that's a tough break right there. That's out of bounds. Maybe the wind just batted him a little bit. I thought that was going to be in bounds for sure. Tough break. Now here's Tim looking to keep it rolling after those couple birdies. Whew, that's got a good move on it. He also gets some of the ground play. Rolls right out there onto the flat. That's in good position. Now, I couldn't tell if Tanner went OB there, but I'm guessing he is. He looks like he's close. He's opted for the forehand approach behind the tree. Great line. We're looking at that in practice. That's the safest line, playing it out to the left of that tree that ducks in. Oh, my goodness. Tim almost rang it up for eagle. That would have been one way to get all those bogeys back right quick. Great shot. Mason put a good move on that drive, so pretty easy up and down for him. Put it up within 10 feet. Now look how close this man is to the basket. Oh my goodness, let's go. What a sick birdie. That's disgusting. Incredible. Getting some daps from the group. Yeah, he only threw 2 shots on that hole. Unfortunately, he has to add one for the penalty, but still a great 3, keeping pace with the field. Oh no. Tim just lets another one slide by. You know he's not happy with that. Mason looking to keep the train moving. Yes, sir, dead center. Moving him to 8 under. He's on a run right now. Here we are in hole 14. Main thing is you get out of this gap right away. If you hit this first initial gap, this hole is a fairly standard disc flight. Basically want to throw something out, let it hyzer over. Don't have much obstruction on the green, so if you throw it the right distance, it should be able to just skip up in there. It's a little bit more left than you think. You got to throw it through the gap and then let the disc finish. Curious to see how these guys attack this hole. It's like Mason's going with a mid-range and that's got a good amount of drift on it. Going with the mortar. It's a little long, but he's going to be putting at it. Now, Ezra, after that monster putt on the last hole, see if he can just keep it rolling here. Silky smooth.
Perk job.
Can't tell if that's closer than Ezra's, but those are both really good shots. Tapping birdies. Well, these guys made this hole look pretty easy. Mason's got a little bit of shrubbery to get around, but looks like he's got an angle at it. Yes, sir. Going to 9 under. This man is on fire. I would guess that this is birdies around for the group. Well done. And proper display of professionalism. Big thanks to our sponsor, Innovadis, and shout out to Chris Shotwell for throwing that last one in. Here we are on hole 15. It's a par 4, 580 feet, and one of the most daunting holes on the course. Slightly uphill to start. You're going to want the disc to kind of drift over. For a righty backhand player, you want something that'll drift over and stay in the fairway. If you can get to the top of the hill, that is super ideal. You've got the one guardian branch. That's going to maybe contest some hyzers over the top. And then this kind of a long valley and then up the hill to the basket. Certainly a par four and, in my opinion, one of the best disc golf holes on the track. Mason sitting at 9 down, and this is where the round can maybe... You know, maybe he can get it going to 11 or 12. Maybe he'll shoot a 7. I mean, these last few holes, you got to get through them. He's put it in the fairway, so looking really good thus far. Ezra with a nice move on that one, but it just came out with hyzer and stood up straight. He needed that to turn over, so that's going to put him in a tough position. More than likely someplace that he's going to have to lay up to try to get his 4. Tim's still got a good round going. He's had some struggles with the putter, but that is pured. What a shot on the roll in the middle. That's such a good shot. I know you can't tell from the video. That was smoked. And Tanner just kind of catching a tough break. Caught a little shrubbery. But he's still in decent position. Looks like he'll be able to make his way up the fairway. And you can also see that there's a lot of rocks on this fairway. Every player kind of has to work with the lies that they get. There's a lot of rocks and uneven ground here, so even really good shots can be tough. Mason seems to have put himself in really good position, directly looking at the basket. Oh, just pulled it just a little bit, caught the branch. He's down in the fairway. Should be able to easily approach and get the 4. Ah, Ezra going with the flick. That was tracking. After an incredible drive. No. Oh, that stupid tree. Tim's still going to have a putt at it, but I know he wanted a park job for sure. Now, Tanner opted to go with the up and over with the flick. Great play. Looks like he's pretty close to the basket. There's not much he can do over on that right side. Mason just chipping up and going to get his par and get out of there. Ezra, same kind of thing. There's a big putt for Tim here. This is for birdie. After the perfect drive, kind of caught a bad break off the tree there. The one that got away. Nice putt from Tanner. Perfect speed, perfect height. That's a great capture right there. Awesome save. Tim tapping on his par. He knows he left one there after the absolute perfection drive. Ezra slaps it in there with the bogey to drop to four. Mason's still at 9 under. He's looking to close it out and got one of the toughest holes on the course. Number 16 is next. Par 5, 912 foot, 277 meters. Ideal landing zone is anywhere right in between those shadows, or maybe just up in front. If you can get out in the open, there's a possibility that you could take the big smash line, or maybe the Simon and Eagle line with the distance. But most normal people will play down this fairway and be looking at hopefully getting a four here. You can see the basket off in the distance after you go 750 feet down a tight tube, and you got another 150 or so out to the left. This is a true par five. Mason's looking focused. It looks like it got away from him just a little. He pulled that one. Oh, good kick. Some love getting the kick back into the fairway. He'll be able to make a play from there. Tim's let this out a little early. It's flying left. Oh, that's not where you want to be. Tanner taking the high road. Looks like he got batted down, but again, pretty nice drop. That's right in the center of the fairway. I'm curious to see if Ezra's going to explode on this shot. Boom, shakalaka. Carry it. Oh, yeah. That is crushed. You see, there's a left fairway there. He might be able to take the hyzer kind of through the left fairway and just play it over the top. Now, Tim playing a sidearm kind of out of the stuff. That was a really good play right in the middle. Looks like Mason's doing the same. He caught a pretty decent break off the tee pad, so put himself in position to throw down there. That's a smart move. Tanner trying to bite off a little bit of extra D. That's looking money. Get out of that stuff. He might be able to make a move from there. That's a good shot. He's probably got 250 or so. Yep, here goes Ezra over the top. Wow, nice turn. Be the one. I couldn't tell from that angle, but he might be jailed. And that is typically what happens when you go for this hole. Mason. Big boom over the top. Looking for a little bit of fade on it. Tim's got the perfect spot here. Smash hyzer. Oh, that looks pretty good. Just got to watch out for the wind. It might drift it too far. Not really. Quality golf shot there. He's going to have a look at birdie. Tanner, like I said, just barely on the edge enough. Get in the hole. Oh. What an out. That's awesome. I was going to say, for Tim to be in the position he is looking at birdie after that drive is seriously awesome. Ezra played the flick out and kind of dropped just where he's going to get a look. Putts up, putts in. From the knee, under the stuff. Low left side stick. Quality. Now, Tim, this to go to 6 under. What a 4. Picking up the birdie. And a sigh of relief after that drive. He did a great job working himself into a good position to have an awesome third shot and put himself in position. Mason with the par. Probably not what he wanted there. He was just barely off, but par is not a terrible score on that hole. On to 17. 252 feet, 96 meter, par 3. Shooter's choice here. You've got a low hyzer route, or you've got a flick shot. Whichever one suits your fancy. Now here's Tim after that awesome 4. Looking to close this round really strong. He's still got a good round going, despite the couple misses on the green. And that's looking textbook. A little ground play. And I think he'll be moving to 7 under after this hole. Tanner, he's making the choice right here. Does he want to backhand it or does he want to flick it? He's chosen the backhand. And that's going to leave him with maybe something just outside 20 feet. Now here's Ezra. He's going for the flick line over the stuff. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's up there inside 20 feet. Mason looks like he's playing his mortar. Going with the backhand route. Oh, he's let this go early. Oh, no. See a lot of guys sneak right through there. That one's kind of an unfortunate break. Didn't slide through for a putt at all. He wisely lays it up under the basket for the 3. Tanner with the nubber from maybe 25, 28 feet. Tough break. Ezra with the birdie. 6 under. After starting 2 over on the first 2 holes, he's worked his way to 6 under par. Mason with the par and Tim with the birdie, putting him to 7 down. Tanner taps in, staying at 2. And on to hole 18 we fly. 678 feet, just over 200 meters. Par 4, up and down the hill. I think most of the players with the distance want to get to the very top of the hill. You see the 2 trees there on the right. Being the only real thing that's in the way of getting to the top. Now you're up here on the plateau and you're gonna drop down and to the right you're gonna see the basket kind of perched on the side hill. Very precarious pin position and one that can provide some drama if you're trying to run a putt. There is definitely a drop off behind the basket. So awesome finishing hole here on hillside. Tim just launched that nice little bump off the tree. That's in pretty good position. And it's a deceptive hole. And Ezra is going to make it look very small. What a smash. Uh-oh, got to watch out for the wind drift. That one got up a little, got away from him just a little bit. Here's Tanner playing that inside out. That's a crush. Miss it. Oh, yeah. That's ideal landing zone. Mason. Looking to go to 10 down. Got a heck of a round going. Oh, no. Whoa, sweet camera angle. A little bit of ground play, and he should be able to get it up and down from there. I don't even know where Ezra is right now. He's over on the other. There's not even another fairway. He's making new routes. Ladies and gentlemen, he is a trailblazer. Good looking shot from Tim, kind of just came up a little short. A quality move. Now Tanner is in great position to attack, especially with his sidearm. Let's see, I expect him to get this one close. Oh yeah. Maybe a 25 footer down the hill. That's, you're loving that. Now Mason playing a sidearm up. Ah, he caught a rock. He just hit a rock and the disc went backwards instead of skipping forwards. That's a 30-foot difference, 40-foot difference. That's kind of a tough break. It's not an easy putt. As Tim pitches up, he's going to get a par here. This is a big putt for Mason. This is for par. Oh, great look on it, just a little bit short. He's going to tap in a bogey. That's going to leave a nasty taste in his mouth. Oh, don't do it. Oh, my goodness. It's one of those times you wish you would have had a full air ball. Ezra recomposes himself. Smash. Well done. Keeping the nerves in check and just going back to work, doing another putt. Oh, Tanner, after putting himself in perfect position after two shots, leaves it low, doesn't convert for the birdie, but he'll have an easy tap out par. Kind of a tough round for Tanner. He just didn't get some of the sweet breaks or slide through some of the stuff. Oh, no. Tim just let that one slip out to the left. Well, he was all over a great round, and that's going to leave a bad taste in his mouth as well. You know, Mason's not super stoked with the finish, but really good round by both those guys. Just a couple holes here and there. Thank you for joining me on the coverage of the Battaga Finals from San Antonio. Big thanks to GK Pro and all the sponsors.